Hello everyone, today we will talk about Azure Blob Storage on IoT Edge. What is it? It is a lightweight Azure consistent module which provides local blob storage. It comes with the configurable ability to automatically upload the data to Azure and provide support for intermittent internet connectivity. It also has the ability to automatically delete the data from the local blob storage account. What all we'll learn today? How to configure and deploy this module? Device to cloud upload functionality in action, device auto delete functionality in action, device to cloud upload functionality in a disconnected scenario. How we'll be doing it? We already have an Azure IoT Edge device running Azure IoT Edge runtime. We'll deploy Azure Blob Storage on IoT Edge module pointing to Edge local blob storage account. We will install Azure Storage Explorer in a desktop and connect it to our local storage account and Azure storage account. Then we'll upload data to our local blob storage account via Azure Storage Explorer and check out device to cloud upload in action. Sounds good? Let's get started. Number 1. How to configure and deploy this module. For this demo, we will be using VS Code. We have an Azure IoT Edge device running Azure IoT runtime. We added this section. Let's call our module local storage. Provide the link to the MCR URL. Provide a name to your local storage account. Provide local storage account key and storage path. Now, let's configure device to cloud upload properties and device auto delete properties as desired properties for this module. For device to cloud upload properties, set upload on to true to turn on this feature. The upload order is set to oldest first. It means my oldest data will be uploaded first. Cloud storage connection string expects connection string to your Azure storage account where the data will be uploaded. Storage containers for upload properties allows you to specify the source and target container names. In this example, we are saying upload the data of cont1 in local blob storage to edge cont1 in Azure blob storage. For cont2, I'm using template string to specify my target container names. For cont3, you can see I have not provided the target container name, hence the module will automatically assign it one. Delete after upload property, then set to true, will automatically delete the data from local storage account after it uploads the data. For device auto delete properties, set delete on to true to turn on this feature. Delete after minute is set to 5 minutes. It means the module will delete the data from local blob storage account after 5 minutes of its last modified time. Retain while uploading, when set to true, will retain the blob while it is uploading even if delete after minute value expires. Let's deploy this module. Now let's refresh. Here is our module. Let's make sure I can ping my IoT device. I have downloaded and installed the Azure Storage Explorer. Now let's connect it to our local storage account. I'll show the connection string format on the screen. Let's create container cont1 in local storage account. Similarly, I created cont2, cont3 and cont4. Number 2. Now it's time to see device to cloud upload functionality in action. I have connected my Azure storage account as well. Let's make sure I don't have any pre-existing containers. Now let's add an image cont1 in the local blob storage account. Wait for a while and refresh. The image magically appears in our Azure storage account. Let's make sure it's the same image I uploaded. Let's see what happened when we added some files to cont2 and cont3. The files appeared in the container in Azure whose names are assigned appropriately as intended. Cont4 is not listed under storage containers for upload. Hence, any data added in this container will not be uploaded to Azure. Number 3. Let's see device auto delete functionality in action. But before that, let's discuss couple of data delete behaviors which you can achieve by using device to cloud upload properties and device auto delete properties in combination. Here are the values you can specify to delete the data from local storage account as soon as delete after minute values expire. With these values in place, let's upload a blob. The module will try its best to upload the blob before the delete after minutes value expires. But it will not retain the blob in local storage account if it cannot. You will observe that the blob is automatically deleted from the local storage account once their delete after minute value expires. Here are the values you can specify to delete the data only when data is successfully uploaded. I have set delete after minutes to 1 minute and retain while tearing and delete after upload are set to true. I added an 11.7 GB blob to the local storage account. It takes more than 1 minute to upload to Azure. You will see, even though delete after minute value expired, it did not delete the blob from the local storage account. Once the module ensures that it successfully uploaded the file, it will automatically delete the blob from the local storage account. Number 4. Let's see device to cloud upload in a disconnected scenario. I'm adding a blob of roughly 11.7 GB to our local storage account. After it is added to the local storage account, let's wait for a while and disconnect the internet from the IoT device. You can see the file did not appear in the Azure storage account. It means it did not finish uploading. Let's wait for a while and reconnect the internet. The module automatically figured out that the internet connection is back again and started uploading the blob. And here is my blob in Azure. For more up-to-date information, go to this URL. Thanks for watching.